Hello my dear audience, in this video I am going to tell you how a positive clamber behaves when a sinusoidal AC signal is given to it. The applied sine wave is having a 0 DC offset value, that is the positive and negative peaks are equidistant from zero. Now, in the analysis, we assume that for all practical purposes, the capacitor gets fully charged or discharged in 5 time constants. What happens during the first positive half cycle? During the first positive half cycle, the diode is reverse biased as the voltage across the capacitor cannot change instantaneously. Therefore, as voltage on input moves up, the voltage across the resistor, load resistor, has to follow the input. So this is how we will draw the voltage during first positive half cycle. Now, when the input AC voltage initially goes negative, then as long as its magnitude is less than diode forward voltage drop, that is, as long as the input voltage is above the minus VD level, the diode remains reverse biased and the output and it output follows the input. Now what happens when the input voltage goes negative and becomes equal to the diode forward voltage drop level? At this point the diode becomes forward biased, allowing the capacitor to charge to the peak of input minus the diode drop VD. Actually, the capacitor does not charge instantaneously to a voltage level determined by the network. That is why in the first negative half cycle up to its negative peak, the output voltage is equal to minus VD, or it is equal to minus 0.7 volt as shown here. Up to first negative peak, output voltage is minus VD. If we assume a silicon diode, it is equal to minus 0.7 volt. Now, during the period just after the negative peak, the diode is reverse biased because of the peak voltage level minus VD, which has now been developed across the charged capacitor. There is some voltage equal to VP minus VD which is developed now across the charged capacitor. Therefore, it will try to make the diode reverse bias, so diode will become in off state. Now the capacitor discharges through a high resistance RL, but it discharges very little from peak of one negative half cycle to the next negative peak if the time constant, that is the product of RL and C, is said to be large enough, that is 10 times the period of input frequency. Therefore, it can be assumed that the capacitor holds on to its established voltage level by retaining the charge and essentially behaves as a battery in series with the input voltage. Now we can say in this circuit, this diode will behave as an open circuit because of this voltage develop on the capacitor. So applying Kirchhoff's voltage law on this loop, we can get V input plus V peak minus Vd minus V output is equal to zero. So that we can say that when V input is minus Vp, V output is equal to minus Vd, and when V input is equal to minus of Vp plus Vd, then your output is equal to zero. So we can say that a clamper has added a DC level to an AC voltage if ideal case, ideal model of diode is considered. We can say that the DC voltage established on the capacitor gets added to the input voltage by superposition, so that the output sum of the two is an upward shifted sine wave with peak voltage Vp. This is the peak voltage riding on a DC level equal to Vp. So now the output wave is symmetrical about the DC reference level equal to Vp, peak value of the input, or you can say output voltage swings about a DC level equal to Vp, and it goes up to 2 Vp. So we can say that it's an upward shifted sine wave whose peak value is still Vp, but now it is riding on a DC level equal to Vp. Here in this case, we can say that when V input is equal to V peak, when V input is equal to V peak, then V output is equal to twice of V peak minus Vd. So we can say that a clamper provides a DC offset level to the input voltage. In this example, we can say that if a sine wave of 20 volt peak to peak voltage or 10 volt peak is applied to a clamper circuit, it provides a DC offset level of 10 volt to the input, so that the output now has a 20 volt maximum peak, 20 volt maximum peak and 0 volt minimum peak. DC offset is basically how many volts above or below a ground the signal is. So if it is assumed that the capacitor gets charged instantaneously, we can say that the output of a positive diode clamper will be as shown in this figure. So we can say that positive unbiased voltage clamping vertically translates the input wave so that all parts of it are approximately greater than 0 volt, the negative swing of output will not dip below minus 0.7 volt, assuming a silicon PN diode. So I have highlighted the output, so we can say that this is a output sine wave which is an upward shifted sine wave with peak value equal to Vp, but now it is symmetrical, or it swings about a DC reference level equal to Vp. So this is all about a positive clamper circuit. If you like my video and if you are really getting some substantial input from my videos, so please like and subscribe. Thank you so much.